Hi guys, Retro Django here. Something strange happened today. I got in contact with a guy that contacted me a couple of days ago because he saw one of my YouTube videos where I compare few Commodore 64 games with Amiga 1200 games. He saw that video and he bought himself an Amiga 600. And he contacted me through YouTube and wrote me that he got inspired and he wants to play Amigas again. A Danish guy, his name is Kip from Copenhagen, and he had problems with his Amiga 600. So we began writing to each other and what was the problem, and he told me that some of the games he played on his Amiga 500, all the old games he had, they didn't work on the Amiga 600. So I talked to him about the magnets in the disc. They are 25, 30 years old and they don't work. And then we found out that the actual problem was the Amiga 600's kickstart version 2.04 or 2.05. So I told him that I could help him with a reload kick, a disc that loads Kickstart 1.3, so he could play the old games. So we just arranged and I visited him today. And I copied some discs to him and he played the old games, North and South and all the old classics, and he was happy. So we played for a couple of hours and had a blast, and I'm sure he's gonna enjoy his Amiga 600 from now on. Really, really nice guy. And on my way out, he said that at the late 90s, he actually used his Amiga to the late 90s, and when he dropped his Amiga, he played a lot of role-playing games on his PC, and those 20-25 year old games, if I was interested, he wanted to give them to me. And I said that I was only interested in Amiga stuff, nothing for personal computers, that just not interesting. And he said, okay, then if I'm not interested, then he will just throw them out. And I said, no way, man, don't just throw them out. So I just asked him, which games is it? And actually, this was the first box he showed me. Diablo 2, the expansion set, and Diablo 2 here. From that era, I mean, Diablo 2 was my favorite game. I just loved playing Diablo 2 and Civilization 2, Civilization 3, but still today, I prefer playing Diablo 2 against Diablo 3. Still, I could, when I look at this box, the artwork, everything, I just want to start a new game and play the Sorceress. It's just so well balanced, well programmed. I loved every time new patches came out and this game got updated. I mean, Diablo 2 is just one of my all-time favorite games. I love them. And the day this game got released, I was in line and I bought it, and I have this game on an original box. But I mean, YouTube donation for free, he said, here you go. And thank you, Kim. So I got Diablo 2 today, YouTube donation, and I got the Diablo 2 expansion set. I also have this one, of course, but I also got this one, Dungeon Siege 2 Deluxe Edition. I actually played this back in the day and it was an awesome, awesome game. I don't remember if I had the deluxe version. It's really old game, you know. Install disk and oh my gosh. Dungeons and Broken World. I don't know if it's an expansion, but
yeah.
Well, I also got this one. I remember it was an awesome game. I haven't played for so many years, so don't know if it holds up today. But I know Diablo 2, awesome. Play it. If you don't have tried it, play it. Well, before Diablo 2, I was obsessed with Command & Conquer. I mean, Command & Conquer and Red Alert, Red Alert 2. Best multiplayer games of that era. I mean, it was just crazy. And this box, I mean, I'm so sorry, it's a little bit dark. It's late in Denmark, but this box actually contains the Command & Conquer universe. Command & Conquer Red Alert, blah, 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 Generals. It contains 12 Command & Conquer games on a single DVD. It's just an awesome, awesome box. I mean, it's also got from the first one up to Generals. And I also loved Command & Conquer Generals. That was also a nice one. But after that, when they made all these crazy 3D futuristic, then I just lost interest. But Generals was always one of my favorites. Also nice multiplayer. So this is actually a game that I could install and play today, just like Diablo 2. I really love it. Then I got this box, Magic Carpet. I played it on my first 486 100 megahertz PC. Magic Carpet 2, very popular back then with all 3D graphics. It was really groundbreaking. But then I got Dungeon Keeper 2. I have never tried, I have never seen Dungeon Keeper 1. But I had Dungeon Keeper 2 and man, it was an awesome game. When I see this, I really want to buy and play Dungeon Keeper 2, but I don't know if it's possible with our computers and Windows 10 today. But yeah, really, really nice donation again. My favorite game of that era, just like After Beholder 2. I have made a review, gameplay video of After Beholder 2 on the Amiga. When I got my PC, I actually played Lands of Lore 1. I have never seen or tried Lands of Lore number 2, but the first one, if you like games like After Beholder, Black Crypt, you have to play Lands of Lore 1. It's more of the same, but I don't dare to say better, but it's really nice. I love Lands of Lore 1 and the story of the game. It was so nice. I mean, look at these pictures. Great condition, guys. Great condition. Again, Westwood. Yeah. But the reason that I'm making this video is not because of those titles, it's because of this. I mean, look at this box. This is crazy. Diablo 2 Battle Chest. It's an awesome pack. I actually saw one of these on eBay once, and I bid on it, and I bid crazy amount on it, and I actually won the action. The auction back then, and paid him the money and all that, and the seller just, he was from France, he just disappeared on me, and I never got the game, and he just, after I paid him, he stopped returning my mails and all that. But this was because I'm a huge Diablo 2 fan. This battle chest, it was just always something that I wanted to buy back then, you know, but now I have the Diablo 2. I have played it so many times. You know, it's not something that I want in my collection anymore, but I just want to film it because I think it's just awesome. Yeah, let's take a look inside. So,
the standard manual. Back then, guys, it was not a manual on a PDF file on a CD. We actually got pictures and descriptions, and these manuals, they were just... So we got another manual here. Yeah. We got a... Walker 3. Oh man, it looks great.
I wish I filmed this with a little bit more light, but sorry guys. The other side, I really love this. Diablo 2, StarCraft, of course. If you played Diablo, if you like Diablo, you would love StarCraft also. Oh my god, it's too dark. I really wish I could show you this, guys. And we got... the ultimate strategy guy.
Wow. I've seen this before. The necromancer, his skills. I would love if I got my Diablo 2 battle chest back then when I played it like crazy. Oh, all the enemies, their hit points and all that.
Nice. Alright.
So we got some, yeah, of course, a lot of game discs. This is the Diablo 2 and... oh, you're getting some CD keys, guys. Diablo 2 again. Why do I have two of the Diablo 2s here? Diablo 2, Lord of Destruction. Diablo 2, Expansion Set? What? This should only be one. Well. Okay, do I have two discs of all games? Nice. Alright. So, okay, that's nice. And we have... guys, this is different. This must be... because my Diablo 2... yeah. The CDs on my Diablo 2 box, they look like this. And also the expansion pack and all that. All the Diablos I've seen, they look like this. And this double CD box, it's with red text. It looks different. That must be this collector's edition box. It's really nice.
No fingerprints, no nothing. Has he? Oh my god! It looks like new!
Okay, I'll take this.
No fingerprints? Nothing?
This is crazy. Looks brand new, guys.
Diablo 1 from 1996? Alright, I got the upper one also. Nice.
And we got...
what? What's the one with the disc and what's this? I don't know, this guy, he must love the upper because every disc he has an extra one. And he has a copy of the other one, the upper two, the upper one.
Oh my god.
The manual for the expansion.
Yeah. Perfect. We got some. What am I gonna do with this? Some Nintendo manuals and some disc from PC games back then. Alright. Worms manual. This must be also Nintendo 64. Banjo-Kazooie. Also Nintendo 64. And, oh, there's a PlayStation. This, I don't know why it's this high, because check terminal. I had Tekken 1, 2, and 3 on PlayStation 1, but I don't know the chapter number up there. Yeah, I don't know why they are included, but I just love this box. It's so awesome. Thank you for the YouTube donation, man. It's just great. And it's not because of I helped him today. He had already... Yeah, they were just ready to be donated to him. I mean, thank you. Yeah, this box is just awesome. Now I have this box. I have these Diablo discs. And I also have my own original. I'm gonna keep my own original, the ones that I bought when they got released. But I have, it's just a mixture. It's nice. I love this Banjo guy. This is awesome, man. Look at this. I mean, if you're a collector, if you collect PC games, this is a must-have, you know? Just wanna share it with you guys today. So until next time, play some more Amiga and maybe some Diablo 2. Bye.